look at this view.
I know, it's stunning.
I'm stunned. You live here.
Well, I house it, the artist.
Oh, he must be successful.
Not really.
No? Well, what'd he do to score this view?
Trust fund.
Trust fund. There you go. Hey, thanks for getting me back my notes. Don't know if I ever said that to you.
You didn't, but it's okay. What are they for, anyway?
Oh, my graduate dissertation.
Oh.
Sounds more impressive than it is. In fact, it sucks. At least that's what my professor told me at our meeting the other day.
If you come up here every day and you look out at the buildings, you start to notice how the view's always changing. New curtains on the windows right there, fifth floor. That flower pot that was not there before. So I come up here every day and I watch the landscape shifting. A coat of paint, a bar that's changed its name. Nothing ever stays the same.
When I was just a little girl, I'd look out my bedroom window and see this skinny little tree out in the garden. And season after season, it grew and grew. And I surmised, though toddler-sized, that I would too. And now here I am with you as we overlook the city. And I think I'm still that girl staring out her window. Ask me why. Warren, tell me about your big picture, how you came to New York to begin it. I mean, somehow you found this big picture.
But the trouble is finding the right way to paint myself in it.
What do you mean? Aren't we all just little specks all huddled together?
I mean, look at me here with my bag full of pages, pages like these.
Wow.
These backpacks of pages, mountains of pages that nobody sees.
Warren, what are you talking about?
I come here every day and see the world evolving from the curtains on the windows to the sky. But I stay just the same, and no one ever sees me because just a charade.
Get down from there.
I'd rather see them fly. I was walking down 16th Street. I decided it was time. Got my stuff from her apartment. All the clothes, I just moved in there. Bunch of books, the tie she made me wear. Did her dishes, left my key. It had been days and where was she?
I couldn't call or even show. I thought it would be best to let him go.
I was stopping at the corner, feeling tense and all shook up. Then for no good reason I look up.
I see a piece of paper falling from the sky. It makes me stop because it's falling from so high. Dancing on the wind all on its own, but it is not alone. There's a swarm, a storm of
red, gold and brown and crimson, blue and violet, pink and amber, orange and yellow, white and green.
down from there.
Look at how far they go when there's nothing to stop them.
Did you make these?
Yeah, it's sort of a project, but no one ever took them.
Warren.
No, they're much better off out there. You gotta see this.
Warren, look. I kept this in my bag. Never let tall buildings block the view of your dreams.
That's mine.
It's a little precious, but it spoke to me.
Oh, keep it. The rest are going over the edge.
Wait. Warren, throw my notes, too.
But what about your thesis?
It's all wrong. This whole thing is wrong. Look at this. I don't even like Virginia Woolf. Her life is depressing. This isn't right. It's not me. It's not my...
life story.
Yeah.
Come here.
Dozens of people reach for the pages that rain.
Look how many people are coming over.
Dozens more looking skyward to see them explain.
Waving. They're waving.
A small piece of paper comes floating my way. It says, don't worry, everything will be okay.
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 Ready?
You bet.
On your mark.
On your mark, get set.
Be the flow into the sky. And the pages that you forget.
Like a blanket spreading out.
High above us. Fall.
Tumbling past windows and
people flooding the square, then through everything.
Warren, it's beautiful.
My cell phone rings.
I know.
It's Claire.
Look.
Claire.
Look.
Claire.